Most people in life are looking at how do I make a life worth living and a return worth having. In order to do that, you have to know how to play right in your community. You see, if you're not someone who wants to put your life at risk in a company where they choose your hours, they choose your wage, they choose your lifetime, and they choose how much time you can spend with your children or your significant other or spouse or wife or husband, then you actually think about how to live a different life. There are plenty of books out in the community on Amazon and in local libraries that talk about how wealth is truly developed. One of my most favorite books that's very educationally valuable to me and others is called Rich Dad Poor Dad, or Kit's follow-up book, Cashflow Quadrants. He is a marvelous man that talks about the development of money just so that people get a concept of how money moves in the world. But if you're not one of those people, you also may be aware of billionaires and remarkable people that make the news and the magazines all across the world. Those people typically have multiple income streams. They do public appearances, they do presentations, they do sales, they do a lot of things. Sometimes they put their name on a product or they put their marketing skills to talking relationally to other people about a product. And that puts mailbox money in, well, their mailbox. It means they make the sale and the person gets on the product or uses the product or uses the service or builds a relationship with the people month after month after month. In my lifetime, I've always been a service provider. And as a service provider, I'm setting my own living wage. I'm choosing my own business schedule. I'm doing my own time management and I'm building a life for me and my family. My goal was not necessarily to be the richest man in the world, but my goal was to always have time for my late son and my late spouse. That was my right as a father, a husband, if you will, a spouse to someone else, and the one responsible pretty much singly, not solely, but pretty fully for paying for three adult lives at the time. You see, a child will always grow and need clothes and food to help them grow and be hearty and healthy. And I can't base that on my mood. Occasionally, we'd have different types of problems in the family, and I'd be the one who was willing to read the English books on parenting and figure out what to do next when you have a wayward child who's not comfortable in the American life, where we have bastards who try to ruin our families. You see, there's always someone that wants to step outside the boundaries of their role. If you are a role player, then you know what your role is in life. If you're not someone who recognizes your role in the community or in your life or in your career or in your profession or in with those that you hold dear, then you might find yourself in an abuse mode. You see, power is not given to people. Power is earned from people. Trust is earned from people over the course of time. And when you build relationships, you spend a lot of time talking to them, texting with them, having fun with them, sending smileys to them, and doing a lot of things that are sometimes straightforward, straight-laced, or sometimes wild, depending on what the relationship boundaries are. You see, I can be a business person, but I'm not going to cross the line physically hugging or kissing any of my colleagues. There are people in my community that do that, but they're usually women doing it with other women, hugging and giving them encouragement. A man doesn't have the same rights. At some point, the guy is looked at kind of odd, and often what happens is the woman reacts poorly to it, and then basically twists what they've been producing. You see, women always do want to do this with guys, and then they turn around and throw it in their face. And so I just prefer to be more like the men that I admire in the world, who write marvelous books, and I choose, like, well, one of the most famous pastors in the world that I won't name. If I get on an elevator, I'm not going to be putting my hands on any girl that's not mine. And when I went to a business conference and I took my spouse with me, we got a marvelous photograph taken of us together with me with my arm around her because she was technically my wife and spouse under any law of God and any law of my responsibilities in the world as a man.